right.
Oh, we are back. I'm not quite sure if we were ever on, but we thought we were, so we're coming back. So there is a little over, there's 7 minutes left in the first quarter. There was a little bit of technical difficulties. The score is 7-0 Commodores, sorry. And there's a flag on the play right now. It is third down in the first quarter.
So that touchdown was by Jamie Shaw.
Yes, an excellent block there. And run work, footwork was amazing in that play.
So it looks like that's going to be on the Grenada Chargers, not to be confused with the Oxford Chargers.
Of course, of course.
Third down and 14.
There's going to be third down and 14. For 14.
That was a 5-yard penalty against the Chargers.
Yes. And he's going to get wrapped up in the backfield.
Ooh.
And he's going to get hit.
That was their quarterback, Abbott Hankins, for the Chargers.
For the Chargers.
He is a junior at Grenada High School.
So their punt team is going to come on for the second time tonight. And that's going to be 4th and 22 with just a little bit over 6 minutes and 10 seconds to go in this first half, first quarter. And the punt's going to be off. And that's going to go around to the 45 and 40, 43, 42 area.
We are at the Lafayette High School football field. So this is a home game for the Commodores, and we are playing the Grenada Chargers. Yes, and the score is 7-0. A little less than 6 minutes left in the first quarter. It will be first down for the Commodores on about 47-yard line. 48.
That's around the 43-yard line.
And
it's going to be a handoff to Jamie. He gets hit. Was that Jamie or was that Lance?
Jamie. No,
it was Lance.
It was Lance.
So no gain. Second down and 10. So the Commodore is going to change it up. And now get the snap off. It's going to be another run. And that he's going to break free.
That was.
Why? And that's another big game by Jamie for around 30 yards. So first down, Commodores. With
how about the 35?
35.
Just a little bit over 5 minutes left in the first quarter. It is 7-0 Commodores and first and 10 for the Commodores as well.
So it looks like he's going to be the first pass for Randy, but it looks like he's just going to run this one instead. He gained around 6 yards on that.
That looked bad, and, you know, Randy's just fast. And he was able to outrun that defender in the backfield and get a pretty nice gain for the Commodores. Not quite a first down, but better than getting tackled in the backfield.
Yep. It's going to be a gain of 5 for the Commodores. Second down and 5 to go. False start
on the Chargers.
Offsides. Offsides on the Grenada Chargers as the Commodore is going to pick up a first down, I think. No, that's going to say that's around, I got like an inch to go. They're going to call it a first down. Yeah, they gave him a first down.
Well, it's basically what it was.
So with four minutes to go, the Commodores are threatening on the 25-yard line. This time it's going to be a pass, and that's a nice pass. Now on
Willie, and it was caught. Not quite sure it was caught.
And there's a flag. That's going to be a pass interference on the Chargers.
Flag on the play.
Pretty nice catch by number 3, Quinshon Twilley for the Commodores. There was a flag on the play.
I think they're going to call that a pass interference on the Chargers.
Pass interference against the Chargers.
That's exactly what they just called it, Kyle. It is pass interference on the Chargers.
He kind of pushed them when he was about to catch it, so. They're going to give them a little bit over 10, 15 yards. And they're going to be inside the 10-yard line or directly on the 10-yard line.
That's a 15-yard penalty and a first down for the Commodores, putting them in pretty good shape to score on this next little play. Run.
First and goal from the 10.
So 10 yards to go. Commodores get set, looking to take an even bigger lead with 3 minutes and 55 seconds to go in the first quarter. That's going to be a run up the middle by Jamie. He's going to get caught up around the 5-yard line. Might have got a little bit more, a little bit less. Inside the 5-yard line. Yep, they're on the 4-yard line, second and goal.
On the 4, second, huh? Wait, so are we live? Okay.
Well, there's a lot of stuff going wrong as the Commodores push it up for maybe a yard. It looks like there's a confrontation in the end zone as they gave a warning to the number 14 on Chargers and number 20 on the Commodores, so they'll have to come out.
That'd be Forbes for the Chargers.
There's number 20 for the Fed.
Webb.
So both of them were told to leave by the ref.
We do see Lance Stewart coming in for Jamie Shaw.
And number 14 for the Commodores is going to step in for Webb.
That'd be Andrew Robinson. And we take.
He's going to run it up the middle and get to around the 2-yard line. So fourth down and goal. I think that's going to be fourth down. Yeah, fourth down. Let's see if they just try to push this one in here. That looks like they might.
Fourth and goal from the 1.
Looks like that's what they're going to do.
Fourth and goal from the 1, and there are no kickers on the field. So.
So 2 minutes and 10 seconds to go. And it's going to be a timeout.
Oh.
Timeout. Grenada.
But, yes, there have been many difficulties in the Lafayette High School home side, not breakfast box, the press box. So that is why we were not live for the first half of the first quarter. But, so now you know if anything happens, the press box is going crazy. So, we hope nothing else happens, but just to let you know.
So, the Commodore is going to come back out and try to get set. As the Chargers now come out, that's Grenada Chargers.
It is 7-0 for the Commodores, a little over 2 minutes left in the first quarter. And it is fourth and goal from the 1-yard line for the Commodores. Looks like they're just going to push this in.
And Randy's going to rush up and take it and just QB push into it. And he's going to get it as he's pulled in by his offensive line.
That was pretty fun to watch.
And that's going to be over celebrating on the Commodores. The because I saw that flag at the guy threw his hand up. I don't know what he was doing, but it looks like there's a flag on the play. It's probably over-celebrating.
He just threw his hand up. That's just celebrating. Over-celebrating would be like blowing a horn or something. I don't know. That seems like that's how it should be for me. I don't really think you can over-celebrate. I mean, if you get points.
You can.
But I know that's a rule, but I don't think it should be, you know? Like, you get points, man. Do what you want.
So the Commodores are going to have to redo it, it looks like.
That is not cool.
Even though the flag was after the play, so it looks like they're just going to have to kick a field goal now. With 1:58 to go, that was a late flag.
That was not cool. I do not appreciate that.
I mean, we didn't get conversation on what the flag was.
It's still unclear as to what the flag was.
The Grenada Chargers head coach is, I think that's the head coach, is arguing and yelling at the ref.
That is not like a pleasant time.
And he's going to get a flag. And the Commodores are going to get pushed up. I don't know.
I don't know if they can get pushed up. They're like at the one. They're going to a gain of half a yard.
Well, I think the flag was. I'm confused. They just called off a flag and then made another flag. So the kicking team, are we gonna kick a field goal?
This is very
not?
Confusing. I'm sorry. I know a little bit. I mean, we're kind of proficient in our football knowledge, but we're confused.
This is like the students are very upset that we're not just playing football.
Yeah. I'm kind of upset at myself. So there was a flag on the Commodores, and then the Charger coach got, well, we think it was on the Commodores. The Charger coach got mad, and the referee threw.
And so, they never told us what the first flag was for.
Yeah, maybe because they canceled it. But the Charger did get on for unsportsmanlike conduct. He was basically playing at this referee, and it looks like they're back at it.
I mean, everybody's confused at the moment. Have we taken like a 10-minute break from the game? So the Commodores seem confused.
Yeah, try to.
And the Chargers look confused.
I'm gonna.
So we're just going to have a bigger break here as we don't know what's going on. And it looks like that's what they're going to be asking the ref over here, like, what's going on. And then that's Coach Fair down there asking the ref. As everybody seems to be confused at the moment, as the Commodores are just going to come back on.
I'm certainly confused.
Okay. And are they? So the Chargers defense is out there, but the Commodore offense, I think Coach Fair is explaining what's going on. And they're going to be coming back on. Looks like they're going to try to push it back in. Is they actually lost 3 yards or 2 yards?
So
they're going to be on the 3 yard line.
Fourth and goal. The kicking team is not on the field, so it looks like they're just going to try to do what they want to do.
He's going to run out the middle by Jamie Shaw. And that's a touchdown, his second of the game.
That will bring it up to 13-0 Commodores with a little less than 2 minutes left in the first quarter after that very confusing 6 or 7 minute break
and it looks
playing
like
football that we had.
Jamie Shaw just got a warning for over-celebration. So, yeah. and the kick is off, and that's going to be good by the Commodores, and they're going to take a long, took a long time. But Commodores are going to take a 14-0 lead here in the first quarter with 1:54 to go. Yeah, well, Commodores come out and kick it back to the Grenada Chargers, and if y'all didn't get to see this, before they've already had two penalties for kicking it out of bounds. Let's see if they can correct themselves on this one and keep it in play. And he sets. And we're off again. This one's going to be straight down the... He's going to let that one go to the 20, and he's going to juke, and he's out around the 31-yard line.
That is 14-0 Commodores with a little less than 2 minutes left in the first quarter. The Chargers have used up two of their three timeouts in the first quarter.
So, the Chargers are going to come out to look to answer this Commodore, the Commodores, and that's going to be run up the middle, and he's just going to get called. And gain on around two or three. So, one minute here to go. And that's going to be a gain of one for them. So third and three for the Chargers. And they get set. And the snap is off. And it's going to be a handoff down the middle. And he'll gain around one and get hit. And so that's pretty much all that they've done so far today. And that's going to be another fourth down for Grenada as they reach under a minute with 45 seconds to go in the first quarter.
It is still 14-0 Commodores at the pretty much end of the first quarter. The ball, I believe, is going to be on the 37. 40. No, never mind. Just disregard what I just said. No, 37.
Yeah. After this punt, the quarter will probably just end. With under 20 seconds to go, the punt is off, and this one's going to bounce up, and around the 39-yard line. So 8 seconds to go in the first quarter, and the Commodores will have to get a playoff. So the Commodores offense come out for the third time, I think. Looking to score and go ahead 21-0 in this game. The Commodores have really dominated this game so far.
Been trying to figure out what happened there during that little break, and we have Lance Stewart, down behind the first down, behind the line of scrimmage.
And sorry to interrupt you, that's the end of the first quarter. Commodores will take a 14-0 lead going into the second quarter. and
not
we're just
a bad spot to be at.
And we're just gonna switch sides and let's see if the Commodores can get behind this hyped crowd here tonight and score some more, as y'all can probably hear the band over me, because they're loud.
We're apparently maybe having a slight band duel. I don't think it's slight, actually. I think it actually is a duel. It is. There are both bands are quite loud tonight.
And that student section is really hyped, too, as they're going along with it.
We hope to be able to bring you a full second quarter. Second quarter.
Actually, we hope to give you a full rest of the game.
Yes, rest of the game. There we go, Kyle. That's correct. But, you know, first quarter is a little splotchy because of the technical difficulties within the press box.
So I said this before y'all could hear me, but on senior night, we're going to be doing a passing of the scooter, and if you don't know what the scooter is, you need to come to a ball game.
Or read my article in the cruiser. You can do that as well.
Yeah, read her article. Shameless plug.
Yes. And Anderson's going to take it up the middle.
And he's just going to rough it up to get a gain of one or two.
Gain of five.
Oh, yeah, because they got tackled.
Yeah. No, it's going to be third down.
So a pretty good run for Randy.
Just gets them back where they started. So.
No, he got a gain of one more. And that's going to be a pass, and he's going to Well, anyway, that's going to be the first time they're going to have to come out and punt in this game. The Commodores have a fourth down and around eight, as they're just going to punt this one away for the first time tonight with a 14-0 lead.
Now we have Drew Dabney out here to punt for the Commodores.
Let's see if he can get a nice kick, punt. And this, somebody is coming on late for the Commodores, on the alignment.
Here's number 14, Andrew Robinson.
It's not really a lineman, but, a blocker.
Yeah, a linebacker.
And that's a nice punt.
Nice.
Inside the 10. And he's gonna get tackled at the 9-yard line.
Quite a nice
and
punt.
And there's flags on the play.
For Dabney.
That was somebody on the opposite side. So, it's kind of fishy, but hey.
Fishy.
I don't know. He might have saw something that we didn't see up here. Maybe like a face mask or something.
Oh, it's seen.
Talking fast, so right.
Oh, that irks
the grammar.
Me. It irks me. It irks me, Kyle. All right. So.
Currently they're on the nine. Oh, okay, that's going to be on the Chargers as they had a holding. Block in the back, sorry. And they're going to be inside the five or on the five, something like that.
White, nice for the Commodores.
Yeah, they were already on the inside of the goal line, so it's half the distance, so it's only 5 yards, where before it would have been 10 yards.
Yes, Kyle, that is correct.
So they're going to start on the 5-yard line. Let's see if the Commodores can get them to get a safety. Get a safety, whatever.
Okay.
My grammar. They're going to run it to the side. Never mind, I got fooled. They ran up the middle.
Yep. See, I saw that they ran up the middle.
We miss things sometimes.
Yes, we do, Kyle. Yes, we do. Okay, that was a 1-yard game for the Chargers. Second and nine for the Chargers on the 6-yard line. Not a great place to be in at this point in this game when it is 14-0 Commodores with a little less than 11 seconds left in the second quarter.
You said 11 seconds.
I said a little less than 11 seconds. And that's going to be a gain of two, three. Maybe.
So, the Commodores are doing pretty good.
They are doing pretty good, Kyle.
So third down and eight.
That was a gain of two. And there are about 10 minutes left in the first half.
See if the Commodores can stop them.
Oh, I believe they can,
Kyle. I believe they can, too.
I believe they can.
They haven't really done anything tonight. That's going to be a pass, and that's going to be lifted. But there's Commodores everywhere, and the jump ball didn't go. Flag.
Flag on who?
That's probably going to be pass interference on the Doors. Commodores. As that was a little late.
Yes, it was quite late, Kyle. And the student section and fans of the Commodores had erupted in boos when they saw that this flag had been thrown. There were about four Commodore defenders coming towards that receiver, but only about two actually made contact.
And they're going to get a first down.
That ain't right, man. That ain't right.
The guy tripped. I saw it. He tripped.
If only they had eyes like Kyle, man. I mean, we're sitting up here ways away. Kyle can see he tripped. Why can't they? You know?
He was right there. He could have clearly seen it. Saw it.
Seen it. Oh, goodness, Kyle. We got some work to do. All right, so there's a little less than 10 minutes left in the first half, and the Chargers are going to take it and go for a run, and they're going to run out into the sideline. That did not look – that looked painful for that. It was brought out of bounds by Quentin James, defender for the Commodores. It is second and five for the Chargers.
With 9 minutes and 35 seconds to go
in the
second
first
quarter.
Half. Or second quarter. We're both right, Kyle. Don't look at me like that.
And that's going to be a flick back to the running back. And he's going to hit his own guys and slow himself down and only get around a gain of two.
This is the first cold weather game the Commodores have experienced so far.
And it's not really that cold.
It really isn't. But, you know, any excuse to break out the Letterman jackets. I see many of them in the crowd. I'm wearing mine myself.
You know, it's in the 60s. It feels pretty good to me.
Which any normal fit person would probably think this is perfect weather. But,
some people.
Any excuse to
anyway,
break out the winter wear.
It's going to be a pass, and he's going to get scrambled up in the backfield.
Oh, that is. And
he's going to keep scrambling, and the Commodores are going to hit him in the backfield.
And that was.
He kind of just ran in a big circle.
Yeah, he really did. It did. That was not a good run for their quarterback, number three, Abbott Hankins, junior quarterback for the
Grenada
Chargers.
So the Commodore defense will be coming out to look. Commodore punt return.
Special teams?
No, that's not special. It's punt return.
Okay.
Special teams is when they.
Yeah, I got it. I thought it looked like there was like they did everything. Okay.
Anyway, the punt's off.
Okay, I know the important
And the Commodores are going to. Ooh, he almost
that was
blocked that.
That was an almost block by Quentin James with the Commodores. Not quite, but almost.
And that one's going to bounce. Wow. It's going to bounce all the way around to the 26-yard line. That took a long roll as it started at the 45 or 40 rolled all the way back to the 26-yard line. Actually, I'm sorry. 16-yard line.
Get it right, Kyle. I mean, God, man. This close to firing you.
So the Commodore offense will be coming back on. And let this score as we get right under 8 minutes with 7:56 to go. First down inside the 20. Looking to, waste some time in the second quarter and get to halftime with a 14-0 lead. And that's going to be a run up the middle that's just not going to go anywhere. I would like to mention the Grenada Chargers only have one timeout left in this half.
They used up their first two timeouts in the first quarter. So we'll see how that fares for the Chargers for the rest of this game.
Yep, and the Commodores have all three of theirs with 7:30 to go in the second quarter, or first half, if you want to say. And the snap is off, and Randy's going to run that one, and he's going to get a hole, and he's going to get pulled down, and they're going to call a flag on that. It looked like a horse collar. And the Commodore student section is chanting, "You can't do that." And that's going to be on
that's
the defense.
That's quite true. You can't do that.
I missed what it was, but they can't do that. So the Commodore is going to have a first down around the 35, I think. I don't know quite where he's going to put. I'm sorry, the 39.
That is first and 10 for the Commodores.
With 7 minutes to go in the second quarter.
Yes, 7 minutes to go.
And the snap off is going to be a throw. And that, wow, Brandon is wide open.
Oh. Ooh.
And he's going to have Butterfingers there, and he's going to drop it as he was getting.
That's quite unexpected for Turnage. Then again, he's usually either running or, so.
Yeah, well, let's see. It's a pretty nice pass by Randy Anderson.
It was quite a nice pass. It was
just an unlucky drop by Brandon. And let's just see if they can come back and have another. Let's see if they can do another pass like that and this time maybe catch it. But it's going to be a run up the middle. And Lance has room. A lot of room. And he's just going to smoke everybody. And nobody's going to catch Lance.
That is touchdown,
that's a touchdown
Commodores.
And he got knocked down.
That was amazing run there by Lance Stewart. The defender at the end just went out and just dove for him, and it's just too quick, man. That Lance Stewart there.
Yep. And so the Commodores have been pretty productive this first half, and it looks like they have a 20-0 lead right now that could easily turn into 21-0 with 6:43 to go.
Looks like members of the student section have taken over the Doors flag.
And they're rushing that.
That, I do believe, is Joe Hogue and Nolan Smith of the junior class.
Yeah, and y'all can't see it, but they're waving it, and they're rushing, yeah.
If you've never seen School Spirit, this is quite a nice example. And that is a kick there by number 88, I do believe, and that would be Foster Westbrook. And so that will bring the score up to 21-0 Commodores with about 6 minutes and 43 seconds left in the first half.
All right, and the Commodores will be kicking it back to them, the Grenada
Chargers,
with 6:43 to go in the second quarter. And that's a bad kick, but it's going to go to the 31, and he's going to be off to the races and get hit around and get brought down at the 51-yard line.
That's a pretty good spot.
49.
It's a pretty good field position for the Chargers, opening up this drive.
And the Commodore, the LaFette band has started to warm up for halftime. And then that will be followed by the, what are you just calling, the LaFette Dolphins, little kids.
Yeah.
They're going to be playing football. I don't know if we're going to be doing, I know we're not going to be commentating it. I don't know if it's going to be on the screen or
not
anything.
Not quite sure what's going to be going on, but we will see. Now, this field position might come to challenge the Commodore defense, which has really been holding strong this game, but it's really our weakness here lately.
Anyway, well, that's going to be a pass play, and that one's going to be a nice pass. Almost intercepted. Dropped by
but
the Commodores.
But incomplete nonetheless.
Good defense by the Commodores right there.
That was good defense. Looks like that might have been number 6. Mathis for the Commodores. Don't quote me on that, though.
Well, 6:30 to go.
In the first half. This is second down on the 50-yard line for the Chargers. That's gonna be a run up the middle.
He's just hammered.
Plowed down by. I do think that. That was
McIntyre.
He was just plowed down by number 58 McIntosh Hunter McIntosh for the Commodores.
He was plastered.
Yes, that did not. That looked like it hurt.
One could say he took the L because he landed
okay,
on that L.
That's funny, Kyle.
Anyway, 5:54 to go,
and
they're rushing. And the quarterback is just going to throw that one on the ground. Intentional grounding,
Pressured by Commodore defense. Pass incomplete. 4th and 11 for the Chargers.
They'll say that was in the area of the receiver. We all know that was.
It was not in the area, but.
It was in the area, but it was intentional grounding.
It was. No doubt.
Yeah. So not intentional grounding, but intentional grounding.
It was, but it wasn't.
Okay. Anyway.
And back to
they'll take
on
this
the field.
Punt, and the Commodore. Oh, and the Commodores almost block it again.
We've been really good at that lately.
And it's fumble. And they're going to have it inside the 15. So turnover as the Commodores just are pressured and he drops it knowing just get pressured.
Come on, man.
So back on defense, the Commodores go. With 5:30 to have to go, and it looks like the Chargers are going to be threatening and we'll get at least 3 here, I would say. Maybe the Commodores can stop them and they miss a field goal. Everything's possible in football. Mm-hmm. Besides 4 points.
Besides 4 that's pretty good, Kyle. All right.
Well, actually, 4 points is possible. But
how far?
1 point is impossible. So.
Well, I mean, you get an extra point.
But that's not what I'm talking about. Well,
you're talking about like a singular 1 point?
Yeah. You can't win a game 1-0. That's the only thing you can't do.
You can't what?
Can't win a game 1-0.
Yeah, no, you can't. You can't. That's a good point.
Only thing impossible in football.
All right, looks like they're going to second down for the Chargers. Looks like they're going to they just shifted their whole offense.
And that's going to be a run, and he's going to get hit. For a gain of around 3, I would say. So they're around the 5-yard line now with 4:30 to go and are trying to just push this one in to have salvaged some points before halftime. As they might get the ball back one more time as there's only 4 minutes to go. But yeah, maybe. Anyway, it's going to be a run.
I don't think they're calling that a touchdown.
1 yard line.
Looks like his knee came down a little bit before.
He tried to. He got down and then he jumped in.
Yeah.
So 4 minutes to go on the 1 yard line as they look to push this one in. First down.
Well, that's what the board says.
I mean, whatever. Whatever floats your boat. Anyway.
I mean, it doesn't really matter.
They're just probably just going to sneak this one in. Yep, touchdown. So 21-6 here
touchdown
with 3:49 to go.
We never like to hear that. We don't like to hear touchdowns for other teams. But yeah, that will bring it up to 21-6. Commodores still have the lead. We'll see if the Chargers can get this extra point.
And that is good. That seems to be the lucky part of the field tonight, as both teams have scored on that side. So it's 21-7 Commodores, and they'll get it back with 3:49 to go. So the Commodores' offense and defense have been pretty good today, so far tonight. Let's see if they can score one more time before halftime. And they're going to be coming out to return this one. And the Grenada is going to be coming out to kick this one off to the Commodores. My throat's getting kind of dry.
Some raindrops on the sheet here. And the score is 21-7 Commodores. A little less than 4 minutes left in the first half. Is the Chargers are about to kick it off to the Commodores, who are looking to make it even bigger of a difference in the scores real quick in the last
few
minutes of this first half.
And the kick is off, and the Commodores are going to be returning for the first time tonight. And he's going to run that one up to the 20 and get around to the 22.
There's a flag on the play. Lynn Stewart is having a pretty good game tonight.
Let's see what this is. So anyway, the Commodores are going to be coming out looking to score one more time, as they've been doing pretty well here tonight. And the recent surge that they have had on offense to begin this season has been great for this Commodore team, because you know they've been scoring a lot. Yeah. So 3:42 to go, and they're just gonna back up the Commodores, and let's see where they're gonna be. It looks like the fifth. Wow. What? Around 10 yards. And that's going to be a run by Jamie. He's got a flag on the play. Another flag. Holding against the Commodores.
I don't know what just happened, Kyle, but that was
interesting. That was a yawn and me trying to talk.
That's not really mixed, Kyle. All right, so.
They're going to get pushed back even more with 3:33 to go.
This is crazy. There's 3 minutes and 33 seconds left on the clock.
Wow.
And somebody needs to make a wish.
I wish we win this football game.
Yep, me too. I don't wish. I know. I know we will, Kyle. I know we will.
You said make a wish, though.
Yes, but that's not the wish. Okay, back to what's on the field. That was Jamie Shaw on the carry for the Commodores. And that brings them up to the Commodore 17.
So the Commodores are going to be running this one. And he's going to get a first down.
Randy
Anderson.
A little bit.
And he's going to get buckled
around the 41, 42.
Yeah.
That is first down and some for the Commodores.
So 2:50 to go in the first half. 21-7, Commodores.
Yes, sir.
First down.
First
and they're going to be setting up, looking to get a
45.
Touchdown to end this first half. Yeah.
Let's hope, Kyle.
Yeah, that's it. So, it's going to be a pass. That's pass interference.
Oh, there was two flags on that play.
And then he hit him in the face.
You see a turnage over there.
Been quite upset.
He just shook his head, having the bigger man attitude over there. Just shook his head at the comments that Charger defender was making. That's the kind of class that our Lafayette football team has.
Well, Commodore's going to get pushed up even more. The 235. First down. Holding or pass interference. 10-yard penalty. First down.
And that'll bring him up to about the 55, 45.
So they're going to get set.
The Charger, 45.
There's going to be a run by Lance, and he's just going to get. And that number 14 for the Grenada Chargers pushed another defender down, which was missed, and then talked smack to him again. So this guy has a real attitude on him tonight.
That is number 14, Emmanuel Forbes, for the Chargers. Not showing much class for the away team tonight. All the Commodores do seem to be handling it well.
It's going to be another run. And Brandon Turnage, oh, they're fighting. Or not. Well,
it was
a friendly push.
A friendly push. That's what we'll call it, Kyle.
Not a quite friendly push.
We are almost an hour into this football game. No. 2 hours. Yes, almost an hour into this football game.
A little bit under 2 minutes to go, 1:57. Third down 10. And he'll take this now. Offside?
There's a flag on the play.
Offside defense. 5-yard penalty, 3rd and 5. They used a tactic right there where they just said hut until they jumped offside.
That's kind of funny. What'd you say they did, Kyle?
A tactic?
Yeah.
They sit there and they just go hut.
That's kind of funny.
Anyway, Jamie is going to be running, and he's going to get hit, and he's going to still go, and he's got the first down. He's a tough man.
That is a tough man, Kyle. That's quite a nice way to put it. And that will be a first down for the Commodores, and doing pretty well in this last little under 2 minutes of the first half, looking to make that gap in between scores a little bit wider, maybe bring it up to 28. Seven, hopefully. Current score is 21-7 Commodores.
And we'll take the snap, and it'll be a throw. And that one's going to be to
Brandon
just beats them. Touchdown! Woo! Commodores!
That was a nice-looking work from Brandon Turnage.
27-7, 1:41 to go.
Turnage, the Alabama commit, is quite the most valuable player on Lafayette, on the Commodores football team.
And since you had a shameless plug before, I'm going to have a shameless plug. I had an article on him, and his all-star thing, his all-American thing, so go check that out.
On the Cruiser website.
Yep. I also retweeted it. Go follow my Twitter at Kyle is Litness.
When somebody has a username for that, just let you know first.
Yeah, don't follow him.
Okay, that was...
That was good. 28-7.
Extra point kicked in by Foster Westbrook, number 88 for the Commodores. all these tickers having numbers in the 80s is really confusing. I'd just like to point that out. There's like an 88, an 87, and an 85. Okay? And that'll bring it up to 28-7 Commodores with 1 minute and 41 seconds left in the first half. Looks like the cheerleaders are throwing out t-shirts and some kind of cup, can. Yes, the cheerleaders and Justin Armin are throwing out cups and cans. And
it looks like they have their pink pom-poms here tonight.
That is for Breast Cancer Awareness Month, which is October, which is the month we are currently in the middle of. So if you didn't know, October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month.
And the punt and the kick is going to be off in a minute, but we are selling shirts for that at school.
Yes.
$15 each. So number 17 will take this one up the middle, and he'll go around, and that's going to be a pretty good run, and he's just going to juke and swerve to around the set 40, 41 yard line.
39 and 38. Okay, in between, you average us together and you get that. Okay, say we're doing all right. Our eyes can only see that much.
So one minute and 30 seconds to go. And Grenada Chargers will be coming up and setting up. And the Commodore defense looks to stop them this time. It reminds you, Grenada only has one timeout, so they're not going to be running a lot here. As seen by that.
That was a pass.
And he dropped it.
Second
and 10, 123.
That was a pass incomplete. But Charger quarterback Hankins, a junior at Grenada High School.
So the snap is off, it's gonna be another throw. He's gonna get hit. What, and they're gonna call a flag on that?
I say they're just doing their jobs.
He touched it. He touched
it. Did.
And then he hit him.
He didn't catch it. It kind of bounced off of him.
Yeah, as soon as he gets down in that catching position
holding
and
it
hits him, we have every right to hit him. And that's what happened in my eyes. That's what I saw. But they're going to give him extra yards. Everything can't always go your way, though.
Kyle with the inspirational thoughts of the day.
Anyway, so the Grenada Chargers are just going to be pushing up. And they're going to have a first down inside the 30 at the 25. And this is going to be another pass. And almost an interception, and he dropped it.
Interception dropped by,
and that was
like
number three.
Number three, yes. Number three, Quinshon Twilley. Interception dropped in the end zone.
Like I said, everything just can't go your way.
Yes. Looks like the Commodores know a little bit too much about that in this first half.
So they're going to line up with that. It's going to be second down for them. Honestly, it should be fourth down on the, 15 yards back.
And
he's just going to run it up and get tackled. And they're probably going to take their time out here.
The last time out. I don't think they
are. They didn't take it. All right. That's good. It's under a minute now.
That is third and seven for the Chargers. 50 and counting left in the
first half. Let's see if this Commodore defense can stop them and hold them with it being third down, actually. So that's going to be a pass, and he's going to get pressured. And he's going to get hit in the backfield. And he's going to
run
into
his own
guy. And he's going to trip and fall and lose about 5 yards. he hurt himself there. And we're under 30 seconds, and they're going to take the timeout. 18 seconds, 18.5 seconds to go with fourth down, and he hurt their field goal chances.
He did hurt their field goal chances.
Anyway, the bands are getting ready, with Grenada's looking quite hyped over there, and ours looking quite
classy.
They don't
even have, they don't have their instruments with them, which is confusing me. I'm not sure what they're doing. Maybe they're just here to watch the Cumberland Band. Yes, the Grenada Band is not going to perform during halftime. The Commodore Band is, because the Grenada Band performed before we started. So this will just be a Commodore performance during halftime. And the Commodores take the field once more. Commodore defense, that is.
And it looks like, are they going to go for this? They might be going for it.
Fourth and 15 for the Chargers.
Yeah, they're going to be going for this. Yeah, and they're going to go for it on fourth down with 18.5 seconds to go.
And 15
yards. And the snap
is
off, and the Commodores are rushing. He's going to get hit in the backfield and continue to go. And that's going to be a short pass, and it's turnover on downs. The Commodores have it with 11.5 seconds to go and three timeouts. Let's see if they can get a few pass plays in here and again, field goal position and maybe take a 31-7 lead.
This first half is setting up quite nicely for the Commodores, I would say.
Yeah, so the Commodores have done quite nice on defense today. They've really improved their last three games.
Yeah.
As it started kind of slow during the beginning of the year, but the last few games, they've been pretty nice.
Yes, that is. Pure improvement coming from the Commodore defense. It's very nice to watch.
It looks like they're just going to kneel it.
They're not even going to try?
And that's all we got for you, as they're just going to let the time run out on this one, and we're going to halftime.
All right, and we will see you in 20 minutes. Thank you for listening to the first half of the Commodore Grenada game at the William L. Buford Stadium here on the campus of Lafayette High School. My name is Murphy Smith, and that was Kyle Traylor. And the score at the end of the first half is 28-7 Commodores, and we will see you.
We'll see you later.
Canon, we put our customers' needs first and value their loyalty. We promise to make your car buying experience exceptional. We now have 16 locations in Mississippi and Arkansas with two convenient locations here in Oxford, Canon Chevrolet Buick Cadillac and Canon Nissan of Oxford. Shop our inventory 24/7 at nobodybeatsacannondeal.com or stop by one of our dealerships for a test drive today. And remember, when the smoke clears, nobody beats a Canon deal. Nobody!
Ranch, just minutes from the Oxford Town Square, is the place where great hunting stories are made. Come spend time with family or just enjoy a relaxing hunt. We have half-day and full-day packages available with or without guide and dogs, and we offer spacious facilities. Great for group hunts or retreats. We also offer white-tailed deer and turkey hunts. Check out our affordable packages online or contact us by phone today to book your hunt. Enjoy all the thrill and excitement that quail hunting has to offer at Little Q Ranch.
That's where it always is.
You gotta run along to the sideline.
all need endurance. That's just a fact. And Endurance Physical Therapy takes that to heart. Endurance Physical Therapy is a clinic that is owned and run by rehabilitation professionals. Their hands-on and personalized approach is designed to give you comfort while you are healing in motion. Endurance Physical Therapy offers personal training, occupational and physical therapy, a top-notch athletic and sports outreach program, and much more. With locations in Oxford, Batesville, Senatobia, Hernando, and now Grenada, visit EnduranceTherapy.com for more information and a full list of their services today.
Everybody, those were the Lafayette Dolphins out there. They played a good game during halftime after the band. And we are back. They put an extra 3 minutes back on the clock for the Commodores. And as we open up this second half, it is 28-7. Commodores.
These times are thrilling. We are a team working hard to create. Students capturing every moment. Working together for the bigger picture. We're even having a little fun. Student built, student run.
I got it.
You got it, Kyle? Thank you. All right. All right. We are about to come back onto the field for the second half, and it will be 28-7 Commodores. We are, seems the Lafayette Commodores are wishing Coach Lee a happy birthday. That is Coach Lee for the Commodore football team. And they've even played a little music to go along with it. Yeah, hey, Kyle.
Contact Coach Riley and more information.
right, and it looks like at the beginning of this second half, the Chargers are about to kick it off to the Commodores and see about making some ground in the first, in this third quarter right here. As we open up, it is 28-7 Commodores. And it is caught, and that looks, he's going to run it up. And going to be down at about the 27, it looks. And that was Lance Stewart on the return. It is just me here right now. I don't quite know where Kyle is, but it is just me, Murphy Smith, holding down the fort here in the Commodore Press Box for your live streaming enjoyment. All right. So it looks like Commodore offense is coming out in the field. That was, yes, that was down at the 27 for the Commodores. And they look to make, gain some yardage here and keep this score gap high in the second half. That's going to be a run up to the side by Jamie Shaw, and there's a flag on the play. We have a few. That would be holding against the Commodores. Doesn't say how much of a penalty that will be, but that is within the first 10 seconds of the second half. It's going to be first and 20 for the Commodores. That's a 10-yard penalty on the 17. And that's going to be a run up the middle. And he's going to get stopped.
Anderson on the carry to the 21.
That was Anderson on the carry to the 21. Second and 16. It's about a gain of 4 for the Commodores. Still 28-7. A little over 11 minutes left in the third quarter. Man, that is a pass complete to Brandon Turnage. Oh, that looks like it was a face mask. And there's a flag on the play. But if there hadn't been, Turnage would have been in the would have been in the end zone. Sorry, stumbled my words.
Well, hi.
Kyle's back. But anyway, that was pass complete to Brandon Turnage. Looks like he ran out about maybe in between the 50 and the 45, but we'll see. It was a flag on the play. We'll be interested to see what that is. Yes, face mask, just as I predicted. That is a face mask against the Chargers. That would be that defender against Brandon Turnage. And it is a first down Commodores. They're going to line up at the Charger 45 here at really the beginning of this third quarter.
Okay. Randy's going to take this snap, and that's going to be a run for a gain of about 4 yards.
That wasn't Anderson. That was Lance Stewart on the carry.
Yeah, I said, like, Randy got the snap.
Okay.
I knew Lance had it.
Okay.
Anyway.
He thinks he can just show back up and run the show. That is a second down and 5 for the Commodores. And that will
be
Jamie Shaw for the carry. He's going to
nice
run it to the left.
It's a nice first down. He just pushed.
Gained him about 6 or so. That will be a first down Commodores.
Well, there's 2 scooters now. I was down there and I saw two while I was searching for the lost child.
Oh, yeah, yeah, that's why Kyle wasn't here. He was searching for a lost child. He's all heroic.
Yeah,
All right, now we got Jamie Shaw going to run up the middle.
For around 8 yards.
Yes, that would be it.
Under 10 minutes to go now in the third quarter.
Moving along quite nicely. I hope we don't have any more confusing delays as we did last time. That'll be second and two for the Commodores.
And that Randy has that one with wide open field, and he jukes with his signature. He's going to get a touchdown.
Nice footwork on Anderson right there. That will be the fifth touchdown for the Commodores tonight. Bringing it up to 34-7, looking to get this extra point.
Yeah, so the Commodores are going to take a 34-7 lead in the third quarter with 9:27 to go. They're fixing to kick this field goal and maybe go up
number
87.
This is going to be number 87, Andrew Pugh, for the field goal extra point attempt.
And that is going to be good.
Yeah, and the kick is good. Bringing it up to 35-7, Commodores. About 9.5 left in the first, in the third quarter.
All right, so the Commodores are going to be kicking it off. And they're going to get set right here. And they're going to take that. Number 17 is going to go the other side of the field. They're going to get some good yardage, but taken down around the 41-yard line.
Kind of just ran in a horizontal line for a little while, not really gaining much yards, but then got up a few around the end there.
It's getting a little bit chillier.
It is. I'm having to stick my hands in my pockets.
And you know those guys that are down there shirtless?
They're not shortless, Kyle. That would not be good. They're shirtless, which is...
Well, they aren't shirtless. They're wearing jeans. So, gotcha.
Oh, goodness. Okay. Back to what's going on the field. Okay.
One guy has shorts.
Okay. Like I said, back to what's going on the field. We got Commodore defense out there.
That's going to be a run up the middle, and he's going to get hit and taken down. That's probably going to be a gain of two. So second down and eight.
I don't need to stay up as late as I do on Thursday night. I always get a little tired around the third quarter.
It's 8:43. And that's going to be a run by the quarterback.
Yes.
Or running back, sorry. And get around.
He is actually a kicker.
Kicker?
Well, no, actually, they have two number 20s in here. That is.
I don't think it's the kicker.
That's Joshua Phillips, a wide receiver, but they also have a 20 named Remington Smith, who's a kicker. That is quite the roster mix-up. But that does look like the wide receiver number 20 instead of the kicker. And there's a flag on the play.
That's a flag. That's going to be on, holding on the Chargers.
Holding against the Chargers. Mm-hmm. That's okay, Kyle.
And that's a pass.
Oh, almost a turn and interception. Something the Commodores are not a stranger to this season or any season.
Brandon tried to go up and get that one.
A little too high.
Yeah.
You know, he has hops, but there's only so much a man can do.
So the punting team out is out.
They're going to have to punt. I believe this is the third Charger punt tonight.
And the punt is off, and it's going to be a fair catch by the Commodores.
Okay.
But it's in front of somebody.
That was interesting. It's like...
I mean, he touched on that's a flag.
Yeah.
You can't do that.
He definitely touched him, but that was not chosen.
He got in front of him where he couldn't catch it.
It looked like, you know, how you just, you're going to block in basketball. It looked kind of like he just stood there.
A screen?
Yeah, screen.
Just a little shout out before. If y'all go ahead and type in the live chat, I am monitoring it, so you could get called out. Kind of dry right now.
It is dry. But if you would like to comment on our live chat, Kyle and I will be responding. Okay. And there we go. That is a run up the middle by number 4, Jamie Shaw, taken down at about the 39. No, 34. That's going to be, Anderson's going to hand it off to number 4, Jamie Shaw, again. And now it looks like he's going to be down at about the 40. 41, excuse me. That will be a first down Commodore with 7.5 minutes left in the third quarter.
The Commodores have really just been dominating this game, really, with the 35-7 lead.
It sometimes gets a little bit boring for us because, we do get some...
We get tired too, people.
Yeah, okay. And that's a quick pass by Anderson, number 14, Andrew Robinson. Looks like he's going to be down
he
at about 43.
Sideline.
That would be a gain of 2. And it'll be second down and 8. So, yes, down at about the 43-yard line. And there's an official's timeout on the field.
That's going to be a run up the middle by Lance. Excuse me. It looks like he's going to get caught around the 12.
Taken down about the 12.
About the 12.
That was a first down and some by the Commodores. And it looks like Stewart's limping off the field. Doesn't look too bad. Still kind of hopping along. Going to get checked out. Oh, almost down on the sideline. Looks like he's pointing it somewhere around his right shin. maybe just a cramp. We'll see. Walking it off now. And it is first and 12 for the Commodores. I mean, first and 10 for the Commodores. On the 12-yard line. And it looks like Anderson's going to keep it and run it to the right. And maybe just short of a touchdown. Yes, out of bounds at the 2.
And the Commodores are threatening right here with a little bit over six minutes.
Yes, just a little over 6 minutes left in the third quarter. The score is still 35-7 Commodores. And now, first and goal for the Commodores on the 2. Looks like.
And Randy's going to hand that off to Jamie, and Jamie's just going to push up for, I think, his.
Didn't really even have to push. He just ran up through him.
Yeah, that's either his third or fourth touchdown.
He's had a pretty good game tonight. Putting points on the board, that will bring it up to 41-7 Commodores. 6:07 left in the third quarter. It's a pretty good place to be if you're a Commodore right now.
And the kick is good. 42-7 Commodores in the third quarter.
All right, so the Commodores about to come out to kick it off for the Chargers to come up and attempt to score. But we've seen how that goes this game. So.
Anyway, the Commodores look to kick it off again, which has happened a lot tonight. Because they really are just blowing them out. And the kick is off, and it's straight down the middle, and they catch it. Number 6, that would be. Oh. And he's going to get wrapped up around the 30.
It really is just creeping along. Never really pushed 37? Out for it. Just kind of a little slight jog in a horizontal line to the left. There are exactly 6 minutes left in the third quarter. We're about halfway through. First and 10 Chargers on the 37. 42-7 here in the third quarter, Commodores. And
it's going to be a run up the middle for a gain of around 4. I'm sorry, not 4, 3.
That was a stop by Keaton Hunter McIntosh with the Commodores. That was a gain of 2. Second and 8 for the Chargers, not the Commodores. Charger is going to be stopped. Just stopped by Quentin James of the Commodores. He's going to keep the Chargers behind that first down line. Maybe even lose some yardage. No. Looks like it's a gain of 1. Shows how much I was watching. Sorry, you guys. It was a little bit of a distraction. All right.
So 4:44 to go in this third quarter with the Commodores running 42-7. They line up on defense. And they take, and Granada takes the snap, and it's a run up the middle. And she's just, he's going to run off to the side and get around.
Down about the 45.
4:20 to go.
At the 45. Fourth and two for the Chargers on the 45-yard line with about a little over 4 minutes left to go in the third quarter.
And they're going to be going for this one. Oh, so they got a new quarterback in. And he fumbled
that
it.
That did not look good. That was pretty sloppy.
And the Commodores said they have it. And the Commodores have returned it. Well, not returned it, but
recovered.
Fallen on it.
Recovered. They fell on it. Yeah, no. Okay. Pretty sloppy handwork there for the Chargers. They quickly put in a new quarterback, and the handoff went south. And there was a fumble, and then the Commodores recovered it. So, looks like the 44.
Yeah, so the Commodores are going to be coming out on offense once again with 3:46 seconds to go with a 42-7 lead in the third quarter. Anyway, the Commodores are going to be coming out. Sorry, Caden disrupted me.
This is going to be first and 10 for the Commodores on the 44. On the Charger 44.
Sorry. It's going to be a run.
A handoff to.
And he's.
That was a handoff to 27. That was handoff number 27. Zacchaeus Woodall.
Anyway, around a gain of 5. Second down. 3:36 to go in the third quarter. I think the Commodore took a timeout.
About time. They hadn't had one yet. But Commodores don't need timeout.
Anyway, let's see if this Commodore offense can drive and get a little bit more yards and run up the score a little bit further as they have a 42-7 lead. And
yeah.
It's like they're starting to put in a lot of backups.
Yeah. Okay, can we just take a minute? Has anybody ever heard of the shark song? Like, you know, the baby shark. Do, 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 do.
Okay. I hate it with a passion.
Yes, it's not very entertaining. But, okay, whenever they play it, the Commodore fans and student section and cheerleaders and dance team, they all go crazy.
Well, that's going to be a run by Jakaius.
And
he's going to get hit in the backfield. And he really couldn't get anywhere with no blocking.
That was a no gain. Third and six for the Commodores.
Okay, for real, y'all. Y'all got to say something in this chat. Say something. Tell me a joke. So three minutes to go, 42-7 Commodores in the third quarter. The Commodores are going to set up. That's going to be another run by the Commodores, and Chakai is going to run this one up the middle, and he's going to have a first down. And he's to the
first down end zone.
25.
Way to redeem himself right there. That was a first down for the Commodores and a little something extra brought to you by Jakaius Woodall. And that puts us in pretty good field position for.
We're going to be hearing that name a lot in the future.
Yes, he is an up and coming star for he's a freshman. All right, looks like that was a run by number 35,
35
or 25,
can't really see. That's number 35.
35, Xavion Stokes. Just get humbled. It is second and 5 for the Commodores. A little over 2 minutes left.
And the Commodores are going to set up again. They're going to take the snap. It's going to be a pass throw to number 17. That's going to be a gain of around 4 yards.
That was a pass number 17, Kylan Vaughn.
Kylan Vaughn.
That's a freshman. And they do have the backup quarterback in, Andrew Moorhead, senior for the Commodores.
I know Kylan, he's a pretty nice guy. He tells a lot of jokes. Pretty nice guy. So 1:30 to go left in the third quarter. And it's gonna be a handoff from number 35. He was pretty quick. That was Stokes.
That's number five, yeah, Stokes, a junior. Like myself. And that will be a first down for the Commodores. And then a little something extra.
And I'm just wondering if they're going to put in Tyrus Carmichael Williams in the first quarter. Because I know a lot of people want to see him play quarterback. Because he's been really hyped and is really good, in my opinion. And that's going to be Ja'Kai's. And he's going to take that one into the end zone for a touchdown.
Possibly a touchdown.
With 1 minute to go
that
in the third quarter, the Commodores are going to take a 48-7 lead.
That's a pretty nice touchdown by freshman Kylan, not Kylan Ball.
Ja'Kai's.
Ja'Kai's Woodall. Number 87, Andrew Pugh, coming for the extra point.
And he's going to have a blocked kick.
Oh, goodness.
And
that kick was blocked. And it's no good.
And the Commodore line just gave up on that. Just really didn't defend for Andrew. And that really wasn't his fault.
No, it was not. And that will make the score 48-7 with 1:02 left in the third quarter.
That's 48-7, the Commodore. Let's see if we see any subs on defense, because that defense has been pretty good. But I know here I have some up-and-coming players on the bench that are going to be starters next year for the next three. So let's just see. On this kickoff, what's going to happen? Yep. So he's going to set up. And that's going to be a kickoff return to around the 37 or 38.
39.
So we got less under a minute until the fourth quarter. Commodores leading 48-7 as they go out on defense. Now let's see if they can stop them. And I think I do see a little bit of new faces out there on the defense. Number 45, who would that be? I think he looks new.
He is new. That is Tatum Gray, a junior. He's a middle linebacker.
And that's going to be overthrown.
And a little to the right. Man. That'll be 2nd and 10 for them from the 39 for the Chargers.
I think that we have a whole new defense out there right now.
Maybe so. Let's look at the numbers.
Number 11 is the main one I see right now.
That's Quentin James. He's a senior.
Quentin James, never mind. He stayed out there then. So yeah. 51 seconds.
All right, it's going to be a run up the middle for number 20 for the Chargers. Oh, and he is just blown by the Commodore defense.
And Quentin is chasing him down.
That is.
Never give up.
Down at about the 10-yard line, maybe nine. And he's gonna be run out of bounds by, as Kyle said, Quentin James, number 11. He's gonna be first down charged at the 13.
So Ganado pushes up into the 20-yard line, or 15 it looks like. I can't quite tell right now. A little bit over the 15, maybe. I don't know. Anyway, they're going to push it up to get around to the 10-yard line. With 18 seconds, 17, 16, 15 to go in the third quarter.
And there, the clock is just going.
Yeah, under 5 seconds. I think they're just going to let this one, and we'll be right back in the fourth quarter.
I'm just going to swap the sides up a little bit.
Yep. Favorite.
Yes, he is quite the favorite of the student section. Hadn't quite figured out why. I mean, he's a great guy, but I don't know what their infatuation is.
He has a great personality. He's in my sixth period.
I was not aware. I don't know the kid very well. All right, that's
going to be
right
up the middle, and they're just going to catch him. I'm sorry, but
okay.
I'm play-by-play your color.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. But I'd already started, Kyle. You were looking at your phone.
I'm trying to look.
Kyle, when you're not available, I'm going to go for it. I'm sorry. Somebody's got to say it.
Well, I was talking. Okay. Anyway, your beta offense is going to line up with third down and 5. Let's see if this Commodore defense can stop him. It's going to be a run, another run, and they're going to catch him and throw him down. And so fourth down. See what they decide to do here. They might be going for it. Fourth and 4. This is gonna be a pass play, and he throws it up, and he's not gonna catch that turnover.
That was
so
incomplete.
Grenada doesn't get anything.
And the Commodores are going to take over first and 10 at the 7. And look to make this gap in between these two. This song has got me. Like, I can't even feel. I can't even say. They're playing a remix of the Mason Ramsey song or whatever.
Well, the offense is coming back on. And looks like My prayer was wished because it looks like number 13.
Your prayer was wished?
Yeah, Tyrus. Tyrus is number 13, if I'm not correct.
Yes, it looks like he is in for quarterback.
You can check that. I'm pretty sure he is.
Yes, that's number 13. That is Tyrus Carmichael Williams, the freshman. This is going to be fun. He's a great guy as well.
He's an outstanding player. And most sports that he plays, he can throw. And he's good at baseball and made the USA team. And his team actually went on to go win the tournament earlier on this year. And that's a fun fact. And Murphy was trying to tell me to say it and wouldn't let me get to it.
No, you said he can throw. And I was like, that's not what I was trying to say. I was like, baseball.
I thought you were trying to say he can throw.
Okay.
But I was trying to say that.
Anyway,
that's going to be a run. Okay. I don't think you're going to get anywhere. And he's pushing. 27 on the defense is kind of upset.
I'd be upset too. I mean, it's 7-48. I think I'd be upset. Just a little bit. Okay. There's about 10 minutes left in the game as a whole.
That's going to be another run. I want to see him throw. But that's going to be a gain of around 2 or 3. And that's going to be third down. Actually, that was a turnover on downs.
Oh, goodness. That's going to be a first and goal on the 9 for the Chargers. It's going to be a run.
And he's going to push that one up inside of the 10 yards.
Yeah. Well, they were already inside the 10. They were on the 9.
Okay. He's going to push that to the about in front of the around the 5. Okay, guys, I'm sleepy. I need to go home and get some sleep. He's going to be on the 6-yard line with 9:10 to go. And he's just going to run it, and he's probably going to get a touchdown here. Actually, no, he's down on the 1-yard line.
That was a stop by Crowder.
I don't know about you, Murphy, but to me it looks like both teams have really just given up on this game.
Really,
as we're not seeing the same fire as we did.
Yeah. Commodores are getting complacent in their fight, and the Grenada just doesn't have any hope. So that makes for a really boring game, which is not fun for me because I'm about to fall asleep anyway.
They can't even push it in.
They cannot, but that does pretty good effort on the Commodores.
So fourth down, and a loss of 1 on that play. Let's see if they try to push this in.
All right, this looks like it's going to be a touchdown.
touchdown Chargers. That'll make it 48-13. Grenada, as they look to kick a field goal. With 7:30 to go in this game. And the field goal is good.
Yeah, just barely.
The Commodores are going to get it right back. And we're going to have to talk over this song. So the Commodores are going to be coming back to look to. I don't know if, like, really just drain the clock out as this game is really just over. But I got to talk and continue talking. So.
Live stream will get shut down if we let this song come in over our voices. So, sorry if we're yelling. But the Commodores are out on the field ready to receive this kick from the Chargers. And
yeah, we're winning 48-17. I mean 14 with 7:28 to go in the fourth quarter, and the song is finally over and the kick is off. And we're going to let that one bounce into the end zone and touchback, Commodores.
Yeah, we're gonna let
and so the Commodores will be looking. Get some young players some experience in this dead game, as the Commodores have already won with 7:28 to go in the fourth quarter. On first round, they come out to look to, give some players some minutes. And some key names out there would be Ja'Kais Woodall, Tyrus Carmichael Williams.
I do believe he's still in for a quarterback.
But that's going to be another handoff, a number, I can't tell who that is. But
35.
We sent him earlier. That's Stokes, I'm pretty sure. Stokes, yeah, Stokes. Now 7:20 to go, 48-14. It looks like people are starting to leave. This game's pretty much over.
Trying to beat the traffic.
What?
Trying to beat the traffic.
Yeah. And there's going to be a flag. I guess unsportsmanlike conduct or something on that play, because they just got 15 yards. I didn't quite see. We were checking over here on the roster. Tyrus is going to take this snap now. It's going to be another handoff. This time by number
39.
Stovall.
Jagger. There we go.
I thought he was a linebacker, but hey, whatever floats your boat.
Yeah.
So under 7 minutes now with 6:46 to go, 48-14 Commodores on second down. Commodores look to drive. Tyrus will take the snap, and it'll be another handoff to Stovall, and he's running up, and he's keep going. He plowed over somebody. First down.
About the 30.
first and 10 Commodores. 6:10 to go in this game in the fourth quarter. They come back out. And look to score touchdowns under 6 minutes to go now. And we're off when the snap is, there you go. It'll be his first pass of the game, which will be incomplete. It was underthrown. That was Tyrus. Looks like Coach Murphy's done too, as I see him starting to walk off.
He just held his hands up. Today is Murph Day, by the way.
He deserves it.
Not me. And when asked, I asked him in the press box earlier, I said, "It's your day. How do you feel about that?" He said, "Every day is my day." And I was, not surprised.
I know, that's a handoff with green in front of, not anymore. But anyway, it's a good run. Yeah. Murphy's really been around for
ever.
Most of us, our mothers, and their cousins.
Okay.
And most of their friends. Everybody knows Murph.
Everybody knows Murph. Whether they've actually had a conversation with him or not, everybody knows who he is.
Really about time we had a day.
And it's another handoff to Stovall. And good block. Oh, but he is a...
He got the first down.
Stovall on the field. The first down has been gotten.
Maybe. Maybe. Maybe not. First down, yeah, first down.
Yeah.
4:40 to go. So that's going to be a handoff again. And Stovall's going to run right into a whole bunch of people. Looks like they're just running this out. Anyway, so the Commodores are going to be making a few switches. 37 and 46 coming off. And a few linemen coming off. And they just got a few throwaway players in, and I think, check, 32, I think.
32,
I think that says 32 right there.
Jason Gross.
Jason, yeah, that's what I thought.
It's Jason.
All right,
let's go.
Jason, yeah. Everybody knows Jason. Everybody knows Jason. For one reason or another. And 22. I think that was 22. Check 22. I think that was. No, that was somebody else. He's a little bit shorter. What number is Forrest Rowe? What? Check. Where is Forrest Rowe? What's his number? Look for Forrest Rowe. I think that was him. So 3 minutes to go. And Tyson's going to throw it. And he dropped. That was a nice throw by Tyrus Carmichael Williams. And it's just dropped by number 41.
Dropped by number 41. We don't have a number 41.
Well.
okay.
Well. That's number 41. Number 8 on there.
Okay, there's not a 41 on the left.
But he's not on the... Oh, and then that's a breakaway run by number 35, Stokes, and he's going to have a touchdown. Stokes. 2:30 to go. 34. I said 54, I thought. Well, we've been scoring a lot tonight.
Yes, we have been a scoring ball game tonight, for the Commodores at least.
the Commodores just look to be having fun on the sideline. This one's pretty much over. I mean, it's not pretty much over. It's settled in stone that this one's over.
There's no way they can get. Do a quick map here, real quick.
And we're off, and that's gonna be a squid crate right down the middle. And he's gonna be running right back up the middle where it came from, and he might be gone. But no, he's gonna get caught. No, he's not actually. And he's gonna get a touchdown. That was nice hustle by Colin Vaughn. He was a little bit slow getting up, but I think he was just disappointed. But no matter, that was not Colin Vaughn, that was Trakias Woodall. That was a nice try. I'm confused. That might have been Trakias Woodall or Colin Vaughn. I couldn't tell. It was one of them. And the kick is good. 55-21. Commodores late in this one. And I think the Commodores are just going to get this one back and just run the clock out. I think everybody's ready to go home.
I'm ready to go home. I'm tired.
Less than 2:30 to go in this game. The Commodores leading 55-21.
If you're listening from the game, there is a fan that would like some Tums if you have them. That fan would be Carly Anderson. So if you have Tums, make your way to the press box. It would be greatly appreciated.
There's going to be a flag on the play. So, the Commodores are going to be coming out a little bit worse field position, but this game's pretty much over, and I don't really think it's going to matter. And, so game's pretty much over, but we gotta still keep going until it's over, and I got to talk over
21.
This music. So,
Commodore.
We've had some pretty good, the back has been pretty good on offense. Not so much on defense, but, you know, they have time to grow. They have plenty of time to grow. But let's just see if this Commodore offense, can just run out the clock so we can just go home.
All right.
So just 2 minutes to go now, to 10, sorry. Tosh takes... Now he takes it, and it's going to be a handoff up the middle by Trakias, and he's going to juke and weave up the field and go out of bounds. So,
when you say weave, you should say bobbing and weave. You know, bobbing and weaving?
But he juked, so he said.
I know, but, like, it flows better to say bobbing and weaving.
Yeah. So I'm pretty sure he went out
of
bounds.
I mean, it was a juke, but, like, just the syntax.
So I'm pretty sure he went out of bounds, but they're not going to stop the clock because who wants to be here? That's going to be another handoff by Trakias. And he's going to run it up the field, and he's going to be hit. Ooh.
That looked kind of painful.
That looked pretty bad. But he's going to...
did look painful.
They're going to take him out. But he looks fine. He seems fine. Trainer did check on him, but he says he's okay. But this Commodore offense is just going to come back on. And Tyrus takes the hand, he's going to hand it off to Stokes, and he's going to have a big game.
That was number 35.
So Stokes. This game is over, guys. See you tomorrow.
Not tomorrow, pal. We're not going to be there tomorrow.
Next week, I guess, if we're doing next week.
Yes, we are. I do believe.
All right, we'll see you next week, guys. As we're done, and the clock hasn't run out, and everybody's just walking. Everybody's ready to go home.
The final is going to be 55-21.
Bye, guys. Now you can talk.
Bye, pal. And it's going to be 55, Commodores, Chargers, 21. Interesting game up until about the middle of the third quarter, and then it just got boring because the Commodores are going to win. But we had a great time tonight. Please tune in every Friday night for Commodore football, brought to you by WLHS 11.
Yep.
My name's Murphy. That's Kyle.
And we'll see y'all next time.
Yes, we will. Have a good night.
At Cannon, we put our customers' needs first and value their loyalty. We promise to make your car buying experience exceptional. We now have 16 locations in Mississippi and Arkansas, with two convenient locations here in Oxford, Cannon Chevrolet Buick Cadillac and Cannon Nissan of Oxford. Shop our inventory 24/7 at nobodybeatsthecannondeal.com or stop by one of our dealerships for a test drive today. And remember, when the smoke clears, nobody beats a Cannon deal. Nobody!
Little Q Ranch, just minutes from the Oxford Town Square, is the place where great hunting stories are made. Come spend time with family or just enjoy a relaxing hunt. We have half-day and full-day packages available with or without guide and dogs, and we offer spacious facilities. Great for group hunts or retreats. We also offer white-tailed deer and turkey hunts. Check out our affordable packages online or contact us by phone today to book your hunt. Enjoy all the thrill and excitement that quail hunting has to offer at Little Q Ranch.
We all need endurance. That's just a fact. And Endurance Physical Therapy takes that to heart. Endurance Physical Therapy is a clinic that is owned and run by rehabilitation professionals. Their hands-on and personalized approach is designed to give you comfort while you are healing in motion. Endurance Physical Therapy offers personal training, occupational and physical therapy, a top-notch athletic and sports outreach program, and much more. With locations in Oxford, Batesville, Senatobia, Hernando, and now Grenada, visit endurancetherapy.com for more information and a full list of their services today.
These times are thrilling. We are a team working hard to create. Students capturing every moment. Working together for the bigger picture. We're even having a little fun. Student built, student run.
I'm Michael Fair, head football coach of Lafayette High School. Welcome to William L. Buford Stadium. We're glad you're here. We're going to need you tonight to cheer on these boys. Go Doors.